Hey, we're going live in a couple of minutes. Tonight it's all biz. So if you are a small business owner or you own your own business or you have a side hustle or you're looking to make your side hustle be your primary career, you definitely want to be tuning in tonight because tonight we have your biz experts. Oh, I was like, what is that? Can you shut that phone off? Like, what? Okay, so hang tight. We're going live shortly. Great guest, Allison Jones. She's the astrologer. She actually read my chart on my birthday, but she's a holistic business coach. And we have Christine Carr. She's like the business guru, you know, for helping small businesses and people that want to get into go into business. So I'm just listening and make sure. Okay. We're going live shortly, so you guys are going to love this. It's a great show tonight. Oh, here's the weather. I thought the weather was on a little earlier. So did everybody have a good weekend? Happy Monday. Monday is happy. It's happy Monday, right? Now it's happy. It's really happy because you get the Just Steph show. And I'm like, what? I gotta like wipe my nose. Oh, you guys get to watch all that. I'm like, I get like this every show. Hi. Oop.
To incorporate a spiritual practice into your routine?
Maria? I know, I
do you want to have more fun and create meaning in your life? Are you so done with the hamster wheel days? I get it, and you can change all that. What if I told you you can come to Sicily with me for 8 nights and your life will never be the same again? You will rub elbows with the locals, visit sacred sites, learn how to cook authentic Sicilian dishes, incorporate a spiritual routine into your day, and transform your life to leave a legacy you can be proud of. You do not want to miss this unique opportunity to learn ancient ways and experience the beauty of Sicily. This is exclusive, 6 people max. This is not your typical bus tour. It's all inclusive except airfare, and I'm going to take exceptional care of you. Get out of Dodge this February 5th through the 13th, that's right, 2023. Check out all the deets at juststeph.com and click Soul Journey Retreats or email me at steph@juststeph.com. Don't miss Sicily with Steph.
Hi, everybody. It's Candy O. You're listening to 95.9 WATD, the South Shore's radio station. And here she comes, Just Steph.
Let's go. Ooh, girl, you're shining like a Fifth Avenue diamond. And they don't make you like they used to. You're never going out of style.
This is the Just Steph Show. I'm your host, Steph Palermo, your Sicilian soul guide, bringing sexy back to Monday nights. Tune in every Monday night from 8 to 10 p.m. for weekly healings, soul readings, special guests, and tips to enhance your life by balancing body, mind, and heart. Make your Monday night sexy right here on WATD 95.9 with Just Steph.
Baby, you're so classic.
Hey, it's Steph Palermo, and it's the Just Steph Show. Everybody has two lives. The second one begins when you realize you only have one. We are second lifers. We're empty nesters, newly single, and those starting over age 3. Your healthy, happy, hip years are just beginning. I'm bringing sexy back to Monday Night Radio. But you can definitely say happy Monday now because it's the Just Steph Show. You do not want to miss tonight and every Monday night because I'm helping you transform your life one glorious day at a time. I'm your intuitive soul guide, healer, radio talk show host, international speaker, and published author. I help Second Lifers discover their spirituality and incorporate it into their lives. I teach my clients and audiences how to meld a spiritual practice with the realities of daily life in order to enjoy the fullest expression of themselves, the complete life package. You want to have depth in your life, meaning, find your purpose, live your purpose. You're done with the old hamster wheel. You do not have to ditch the divine to be connected. You do not have to ditch the fun to be connected to the divine. I'm a little backwards tonight. Well, don't ditch the divine. Yeah, either, yeah, whatever. The weekend, just the weekend, right? So I offer soul journey retreats in Sicily, one-on-one soul journey guidance workshops, and a weekly talk show on right here on WATD, the South Shores radio station, 95.9 FM. So before we get started, let's have a little quick settling in, little breathing. Yeah, I know some of you go, no, this is just too woo-woo for me, but just do it because it'll feel good. You'll get to relax finally, release the stress. I'm doing all the work here tonight, so just breathe, breathe. And know that tonight and every night when you listen to the Just Steph Show, you get exactly what you need. The universe has your back. You hear what you need to hear every single week. And tonight is no different. So, yeah. Okay, breathe. All right. So I'm going to pull a grace card for you. Let's get started with all the fun. We're going to pull a grace card right from the middle. Here we go. Oh, this is interesting. I'm not sure I like this one. Correct your mistakes. What does that mean? You know, I think that it's, you know, maybe there's a little apologizing going on, saying sorry, your forgiveness. You know, sometimes we talk when we're not supposed to talk, and you just gotta figure it out and say sorry, and it's all okay. There's really not much that can't be fixed and resolved, and if people can't be forgiving or understanding, then they're not meant to be in your lives anyway. So I just have a few little things to say because I thought about this. I actually was meditating and journaling, and I was thinking about something that I was listening to in my Infinite Possibilities book because I'm listening to the audiobook. And Mike Dooley says, evil always, always self-destructs. So I was thinking about this time of year being, you know, it's sort of juxtaposed in the sense that people have so many anxieties, there's a lot of depression, there's, memories, and we're going to talk about this a little later on too. And then we see all the goodness that comes out, the great stories of people, the do-gooders, I don't know if you heard this, Larry, about the guy that in Quincy, some years ago at Howe's Neck, he was really grouchy. He had a store. He was a real Scrooge, and nobody liked him. And when he passed away, he left enough money for eight decades of gifts. He's given out 30,000 Christmas gifts with the legacy that he left behind. So, discount some people when they're a little grouchy. Maybe there's something good inside. Everybody has something good inside of them. But what I want to say with this is that only true good can survive and carry on. That's why we continue to live and reproduce, and the humankind keeps continuing, and the animals and beautiful plant life. So there is good. There are good people. You know, there is light. And if you change your perspective, you will only see the good. You'll see the light. And, Boston's a great, everyone's like, they're trying to stick it to me. No one's trying to do that. If you say that, then they are. Nobody can hurt you. You've got this. You are loved. God has your back. The universe has your back. Which sort of comes into, sort of segues into, I want to talk a little bit about your beliefs. See, our beliefs are actually more important than our thoughts, because the beliefs are what fuels our thoughts, our emotions, and our actions. Our beliefs come first, influencing those thoughts, words, actions, and then the world around us. As one believes, so shall one think. So what you believe, that's what you know, that's what comes out. And even if it's subconscious, and we have these subconscious beliefs and we sabotage situations in our lives and we don't even know why. And then we just go, oh yeah, you know, there was something that happened way back when that caused me to believe that this is going to be a bad situation. Beliefs are why people succeed in sports, music, business, and everything else. So sports figures, they actually visualize. They do a lot of visualizing. They visualize themselves, you know, making the baskets, hitting the home runs, knocking the guy out. Like Muhammad Ali, didn't he? He said, I said I was great before I was. And, you know, he had that foresight. The Wright brothers could not have first dreamed of flight and then flown if they didn't first believe it was possible. Your life won't change unless your beliefs change. But all beliefs can be changed. So if you have beliefs that don't serve you, if you can at least get them to surface, you can start sort of critiquing them and seeing what is working for you and what, you know, what is not working for you. Even your body is your manifestation, and its physical condition reflects your beliefs about it. So all of us who struggle with health issues, weight, cholesterol, whether it's autoimmune or whatever we're struggling with, you know, especially as we get older, we believe that this is the way it's supposed to be, or we accept it and we continue to perpetuate it by our beliefs, thoughts, words, and actions. So everything you manifest in your world, everything that's in your world, you've manifested, whether you liked it or not, whether you want it or not. It's by what you're thinking and feeling, doing, and believing, that's what you have in front of you. So if you don't like what's happening in front of you, you don't like what you're living, then you need to start. I think it's easier to start with your thought process, because you can start to be mindful of the thoughts. And when those thoughts come up, you can critique them and then start to ask questions like, why am I thinking this way? Why do I feel this way? And then that can the beliefs that you that are the foundation for those thoughts, words, and actions will surface, because you can start to ask questions about what you're saying and doing. And when they surface, you can let them go and just release them. Yep, you can let those beliefs go. So that's part of infinite possibilities, and that's what I'm teaching in workshops. So if you're interested in learning infinite possibilities, I'm a certified infinite possibilities trainer, and I would be happy to come into your business and give a workshop in terms of getting your corporate world or your business world ready for 2023, or if you if you want to personally grow, I will help you with infinite possibilities as well. If you have a group, I'll be happy to come in and chat with all of you. So here's what's happening tonight. It's all biz this week. We're all about business. So my featured businesses are Allison Jones. Now she was here back on Halloween talking about astrology, and she actually has read my chart. She read my chart on my birthday this year. She is a holistic business coach, and we're going to find out what that means. And I think she also works around mindset and, manifesting money. And we have Christine Carr, and Christine's doing some amazing work with new businesses. And there's so many free opportunities for courses, and she's partnered with Verizon for this, and she's from Launch Mechanic, and she's going to help us move forward with our businesses. Your soul block this week is we're going to talk about how living in the past keeps you from your growth. And for your soul guidance, I was going to talk about acceptance, but, you know, it's my prerogative to change things as I go along. I really want to talk to you a little bit about regrets and sort of towards the end of life regrets. And I think that if you can make some changes now, your soul will be at peace and you can move forward in your life and know that you won't have any of those regrets anytime. And during the Just Steph Rules of Dating, we're going to be talking about how you can let your guard down and be a little bit more vulnerable because we're coming into the new year. It's New Year's Eve. Who do you want to kiss on New Year's? And so you want to maybe let somebody in your heart and move forward into 2023 if that's what you want in your life, if you want a relationship. And for your social 411, we're going to talk about some New Year's events in Boston that are coming up. But I'm also going to tell you, before I get into those, I found some great places in, for Christmas Day dinner, and we have much, much more. So make sure you give me a call tonight. Call me
anytime. Call me. All right. Be sure to be part of the show today.
Wow. I'm getting everything backwards. Be part of the show today. Call in and ask me or any of my featured businesses, 781-837-4900. Tell me what's going on in your life. I want to hear from you. And let's hear from Liz Teresa.
I love books that give a real glimpse into a culture while also imparting life lessons. There's not many books like this, and my favorite one that stayed with me, it's called It's Not Personal, Sunny, It's Business by Steph Palermo. In this book, Steph combines the pillars of Sicilian heritage with her own life experiences into a book that's truly going to transform the way you think about life and the way you think about work. Stop postponing living your best, most satisfying life, and stop putting off thriving in your business. You can do both of those things right now. Just go to buystephsbook.com and order your copy today. You won't regret it. That's www.buystephsbook.com. See you there.
Healing Vibrations Reiki and Sound Healing of Plymouth, Massachusetts offers private healing sessions in their cozy treehouse-like studio in Plymouth. Lori Fitzpatrick is a trained and certified sound healer and a Reiki practitioner who uniquely combines the healing modalities of indigenous sound, crystal, and Himalayan vibration with powerful Reiki energy to remove toxic blockages that are stored within the physical, mental, and emotional body. Lori also works closely with her husband, Michael Balonis, a certified sound healer, to offer quality sound baths around the South Shore at various yoga, wellness, and health centers. In addition, they will come to your home to host private events. You can reach Healing Vibrations at 508-360-6316 or email them at heal@sacredcrossing.com. You can also find them on Facebook at Healing Vibrations Reiki and Sound Healing and on Instagram at Healing Vibrations 777.
Thank you, Liz and Lori. Okay, everybody ready for a little healing? Because, you know, it's that time of the year. It's actually, you know, there's always room for healing in everybody's lives. The source of all healing is love. Be healed daily by connecting to divine love. Okay, Spirit, you are the source of love, healing, and restoration. We thank you for the miracles you still perform today. Tonight, bestow your grace on those listening who are in need of your healing. Bring peace, restoration, and full health to this audience and their loved ones, especially over these holidays. I believe in the healing power of faith and prayer, and I ask you to begin your mighty work in the lives of my audience. Let this holiday season be filled with peace, laughter, health, and joy. Please reach down and surround my audience with supernatural peace and strength and give my audience the faith to believe that all things are possible for you, Spirit. Amen. And if you would like healing in your life, email me at steph@juststeph.com and give me a call tonight if you have any questions or comments on any of the topics. And if you have questions for my guests coming up, 781-837-4900. We're going to take a short break. And when we come back, this week's Soul Walk and my first featured biz, Allison Jones. This is my favorite. Oh my God. I wish you guys could hear the song, but I can't even play because Facebook is a pain. This is my favorite. This song is my favorite. Number one. Yeah. So how's everybody doing tonight? Did everybody have a good weekend? Let's see. Okay. Realize it was sand on the rooftop. Let's see. Let's see who's. Let's see. I want to see who's. Who's watching? Oh, Maria, you had a great weekend. Yay. I'm so glad. It was fun. Yay. Where's Michelle? Is she watching? So let's see. We have a great show tonight. So what else is everybody up to? I'm just making sure this is on. We're live. Okay, we're all good. I love this song. I don't know if Maria's watching, Michelle's watching.
I know, right?
Let me see where we're at. Some people think the man's a myth. Criticize what somebody says with that look. There was Santa on the rooftop. My house. I wish you could hear this song. It's the best. It's my favorite. I save all my favorite ones to close to Christmas.
Destination, my friend.
I'm going to be at the airport tomorrow at 4:30 a.m.
When I told them I saw Santa on the rooftop.
And love lingerie. I'm Steph Palermo, and I like to feel beautiful. I know you do too. My good friend Maria Paola is the founder and CEO of the Women of Boston Lingerie. At the Women of Boston Lingerie, they have a mission to help every woman feel beautiful and sexy, no matter what shape, size, or age. They offer private, full-service styling with bra sizing and boudoir photography right in their studio in Newton, Massachusetts. Check them out online at the Women of Boston Lingerie at www.thewomenofboston.com or give Maria a call at 617-953-4647. You know, Just Steph is all about living your best life, and feeling beautiful is definitely part of it. So check out the Women of Boston Lingerie and tell them Just Steph sent you.
All right. So give me a call if you have any questions or comments. 781-837-4900. Here we go. Call me anytime. All right. So if you guys would get a copy of my book, I'd be so happy on Amazon.com. It's not personal, Sonny. It's business. How to run your family life and business like a Sicilian. It really has great tips. It's very easy book to read. It's a great gift to give. Great stocking stuffer. And it has tips on how to incorporate what I call the 10 pillars of Sicilian life into your family life and business. Making your business, creating a family atmosphere in your business. You don't want to miss it. Amazon.com. It's not personal, Sonny. It's business. So definitely pick up a copy of my book or get it on Amazon, because it will really be helpful to me if you do that. Thank you. So this week's Soul Block is brought to you by Annie's Pure and Simple. Clean your house, clean your soul. Available at all Whole Foods supermarkets. And here's the big news. If you didn't hear it before, when you want to get Annie's Pure and Simple, you definitely want to enter the promo code at the checkout. It's Just Steph 15 off. That's JustSTEPH 15 off. Just Steph 15 off. You'll get 15% off everything you purchase with Annie's Pure and Simple. AnniesPureAndSimple.com. Okay, so here is your soul block.
Soul block of fucking people. If you're quitting to run, come right now.
Before I get into the soul block, so I've been binge watching Lucifer on Netflix, Larry, and I heard my soul block song in there. I was like, oh, it's my song. Yeah, that's right. That's right. I love it. So, so today for your soul block, I want to talk about living in the past. You know, living in the past basically is depression, and being worried about the future is anxiety. And the holidays bring all this up, especially with the past. Now, a lot of times, living in the past, when you bring forward all the pain that you had in your past, all that can happen. But tonight I want to talk about how, especially at this age, we go, what happened to the good old days? You know, what happened to the good old days? You know, but, you know, first I want to say something. Today... Right now, this is tomorrow's good old days. So why don't you think about that? Like, this is the good old days right now. One day we're going to look back and we go, oh my God, remember when you were on the radio? Those were the good old days, right? And so, you know, we think fondly of our childhood years. We remember those good, you know, the dog days of summer when we drank out of the hose, the garden hose, and nobody cared. And, you know, stupid things like sharing cigarettes and even, you know, taking bites off people's candy bars and not caring what, you know, if they were, you know, had some sort of, you know, disease or whatever. Nobody cared about that stuff. Everybody was free and liberated back in the good old days. But, you know, the thing is, you know, what happens is we have this great freedom as children, and, you know, we're running around getting dirty. We're not worried about when anyone's thinking. We're laughing till the milk comes out of our noses. and, you know, doing goofy things and just enjoying life. And you'll say, well, we just can't do that anymore, Steph, because, you know, I've got a real job and I've got kids to take care of. I'm sorry. My kids, we crack up. I mean, you can live the good old days right now. You can create the good old days. You know, I think that, you know, it's normal to feel nostalgic, especially at this time of year when, you know, of course we've lost people in our lives but I think people who are constantly talking about the past and living in that past, like, you know, wishing that it was still 1972, you know, there's a problem with that because it blocks them from actually evolving and growing, because you have to move forward. You have to do that. And, you know, why are you not happy in the present moment? You know, you're kind of stuck. It's like a time warp. And maybe you felt freer, happier, more successful, more loved. Your relationships were not as complicated, so to speak. But I will tell you this, the reason why it's none of those things right now is because of your beliefs. And it's a sign that you're actually, if you're saying what happened to the good old days, it's a sign that you're disappointed with where you are right now, with the state of the world, with what's going on in your life, with your relationships, with your job, with your health. You're disappointed. And when you live in that disappointment, I just talked about this. This is what you're going to continue to manifest in your life, because what you believe is, you know. And don't shoot on yourself. We talked about this before too. I should have been a successful lawyer. I should have had more money. I should have never married somebody, then got divorced or whatever. I should have had children. I shouldn't have had children. And should statements can lead to increased panic, anxiety, and even depression. You know, when you think about that, when you think about all those shoulds, when you're shoulding on yourself, how do you feel about that? Like what's going on? What's going on in your mind? What's going on in your heart? You know, we feel guilt about where we're at, shame maybe. You know, it's not really the life that we thought we were going to have. It's not what we expected. It's actually aggression directed towards yourself, and it's self-punishment and anger. It's self-loathing and hate. And what I want to say to you here is that all of that is suffering, but you're in a jail cell that has an open door. You're just sitting there thinking that you can't get out, and you can. You're holding on to the suffering. You're addicted to it. There's actually a physiological response to suffering. And when you suffer so much, whether it's anxiety, whatever it is you're suffering, your physical body has a certain physical reaction to it. And when you feel peace, your body actually craves that adrenaline or that other physical reaction that you had. So isn't it time to make peace with yourself? Peace, you know, with yourself and the decisions that you made to get to where you are today. You know, forgiving ourselves is a lot harder than forgiving others. And then let that go. Let that go. It sounds, you know, I'm saying it sounds like it's easy. I know. Let it go. But the way you can let it go is by looking in the mirror and acknowledging your amazingness, your talents, your gift, the gift of yourself. The greatest gift you can give is the gift of self, who you are, your authentic self. And you want to get unstuck. That's being stuck. And start imagining your future. Live your life every day in awe I think the greatest tragedy in humankind, in human history, is that we've lost the sense of awe. There's no awe anymore. There's no awe. We're not moved. It's just so easy to see things on the internet. It's so easy to, you know, if you haven't seen a beautiful sunset, well, just Google it. You know, you can see it there. But even then, there's a sense of, you should have a sense of awe. I don't want to say should, because you don't want to should in yourself. But you understand what I'm saying. Awe. And awe with life. And imagine your future and begin working towards it. Love your life right now. Love where you are right now. And that sort of just segues right into, I want to tell you a little bit about, I used to go on a retreat every year. I went for many, many years, It had to be 10 or 15 years in a row. I would make an annual silent retreat. Can you believe that? Chatty Cathy here. And I actually looked forward to it. I made a silent retreat every year. I went away. It was a 4-day silent retreat. And we listened to talks. And, you know, there was mass and you had opportunities to get spiritual direction and things like that. But then everything else was silent. No, you know, there's no cell phones, no computers. It was absolute silence. You know, we were writing things down. And those days, I remember, those retreats were really hard because I was really peeling the onion back and looking at the not so pretty image of myself in the mirror, and which was good because it was reflecting and, okay, these are the things that need to go. And it's a lot of these things that you can do right now in terms of bringing up those beliefs and all of that. And really trying to understand what my purpose was. And I spent a lot of time in these retreats. And as I was evolving my yard, growing my retreat and deciding what I wanted to share with people and having it evolve into something that I really think people would love, I started to look at it and I said, you know, going on retreat and a real retreat, like a silent retreat like that, it's a lot of work. And I don't know about you, but, you know, I need a vacation. We need a break, right? And so I'm doing something that nobody's doing. I'm melding vacation. It's vacation meets retreat. So what I want to share with you is that on my retreats in Sicily, you're going to experience, it's experiential. So there's not so much work to do, but more enjoying and experiencing peace, calm, clarity, getting off the hamster wheel, walking by the sea, all these kinds of things that, you know, rubbing elbows with the Sicilians, understanding the way that they live their life. And a lot of what I could talk about it all day long, but you need to experience. I liken it to certain, like patience. Patience is, you know, it's experiential. You have to experience what it feels like to be patient. And everybody, all of the manifestation gurus out there want you to feel what you want to manifest. Feel it, you know, think about it, say it, and feel it. Have the feelings. Well, how can you feel something if you don't really know what it actually feels like to walk in that path? Well, you can do this when you come on my retreat because I'm melding my soul journey sessions with the retreat. In other words, go on the retreat, experience the, I'm calling it a recation, like it's like a vacation and a retreat together. You'll experience what it feels like. And then when you come back, you get to spend time with me in your sessions, and we'll have 6 sessions afterwards, 1 before and 6 and 6 after. So, It's going to be a great time. So it's, you'll get to experience true freedom, breathing, no stress, rest and recharging, authentic, healthy relationships, lots of fun, and lots of laughter. So I definitely wanted you to understand what I'm doing, because if I were you, I would say, I'm not going on retreat and doing all that work. I want to relax. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a lot of resting, shopping at the Gucci outlets, all of that. It's going to be super fun. So you're going to love it. So we're going to take a short break. When we come back, Allison Jones, the holistic business coach. I can't hear you. Okay. All right. Okay, can you talk now? Can you hear me? Okay. All right. I just want to make sure there's no feedback. Okay, perfect. 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 Because when you're on, I'm going to put on the volume. So everybody on Facebook can see you now. So you're on. Yay. So everybody, Allison's coming on in a few minutes. I'm just talking to the audience. So Allison's going to be coming on, and I had her so you can see her because she's so nice. I wish I could share this music with you guys. Good job.
There, this is just Steph. You know I'm all about looking and feeling your best. Wouldn't you love to look like you just returned from a tropical vacation without leaving town? Then Sun City Tanning in Pembroke is the answer. Get results in 7 minutes from their updated equipment designed to protect your skin. Enjoy AC and cool spray mist for a relaxing session every visit. They also offer VersaPro spray tanning. And listen to this. Sun City Tanning has the only photobiomodulation chamber in Massachusetts used by pro athletes to reduce pain and inflammation. And the best part, your first session is free. So call 781-826-2605 to schedule an appointment or book online at suncitypembroke.com. look and feel great with Sun City Tanning.
Hey, Boston, how you doing? Chris Cerrone here, better known as the Kid Henry from Goodfellas. And if you didn't know, one of my great friends here in Boston is Just Steph, as in the Just Steph Show. Make sure you tune in every Monday night, or I'll come looking for you.
Thanks, Chris. You're the best.
All right. I'm so excited for my first featured business. I love this girl. She's awesome. Allison Chamberlain Jones. She's on the line. Allison Jones is a holistic business coach, astrologer, yoga instructor, and Reiki practitioner. Once a former travel agent, she's been a spiritual and wellness entrepreneur for over 10 years. She is passionate about blending business and spirituality and loves supporting other people in creating the lifestyle of their dreams. Allison loves blending Eastern modalities with Western psychology and helping her clients to cultivate wealth and abundance on all levels. Yay! Over the years, she's worked in different yoga studios and wellness centers and also co-owned a yoga studio in the Metro Boston area from 2017 to 2021. She is now the owner of Allison Jones Coaching, Astrology, and Wellness and lives in Bradenton, Florida. She works with clients all over the world, helping them experience wealth and abundance and cultivate the career and business of their dreams. Allison does coaching, astrology, private yoga instruction, and mind and body wellness sessions, all virtually online via Zoom. Her website is AllisonChamberlainJones.com. She's on Facebook and Instagram. So welcome
back to the show, Allison.
Thank you. Oh, you can hear me. Okay, good. Because I'm on my phone. Yeah, it popped up like your mic is muted, but nope.
Yes, I know. So I know. Yay. It gets a little wonky here with technology, but we're making it work
because we can do it.
Yeah, because and I have, for everybody who's listening on terrestrial radio, I have Allison on Restream, but we have to make sure that we don't get any feedback and all the technology. So she's here. So I'm so excited to have you back. Yeah.
Thank you so much for having me and inviting me. It's an honor. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Back on the show.
Thank you. So let's talk, let's jump right in because basically if you're a business owner or you have a side hustle, if you're looking to make that side hustle your primary job, whatever you're doing in terms of business, Allison's here to help. So what exactly is holistic business coaching?
So that is a great question. Holistic business coaching is essentially blending a couple of different things together. There's what we would put under the umbrella of strategy. And that's something that when you think of business that you might think of right away, like, oh, I need help with my marketing. I need help figuring out what prices to charge or who my ideal client is, mm-hmm. Things like that. But that is really only one piece of the puzzle. And if I'm being honest, I think that the other elements are usually more important for people, the energetic and emotional piece.
Right.
So much of any kind of success that you could experience in the world depends on how you feel about yourself and how you feel on the inside, right? So with holistic business coaching, we're looking at, we want you to have success in all areas. So we want you to make whatever kind of money you want to make, work with the people that you want to work with, share what you love with the world, feel abundant in all areas, not just your bank account. So I use the word holistic because I bring in some other tools and modalities that can help with the energetic and emotional piece as well as the strategic. So I hope that makes sense.
Well, yeah, because it if you're not aligned to what you're doing, then, it's not going to feel good. First of all, you're not going to love it. I've had so many things throughout my own, morphing my business, where I was just like, I hate this. I'm not doing it anymore.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So
and what I find, something that I find often is usually the people that I tend to work with are people that they have a passion for something,
right?
And they decided that they wanted to, you know, share that passion on a bigger scale. They didn't want it to be just a hobby anymore, or just a, maybe, you know, just a side hustle. Maybe they want this to be their full-time career, and they're really good and really gifted at that thing, but maybe they have zero business experience, or they've never even considered that how they think, feel, and behave around money, let's say, the kind of impact that could have in their business. Like, that might have never crossed their mind before. Yeah.
So who do you help?
It tends to be people that are in what I would call either the holistic, wellness, or spiritual arena. So this can look like acupuncturists, massage therapists, yoga teachers, coaches, therapists, mental health therapists, psychic mediums, astrologers, Reiki practitioners. You don't have to be that, but you kind of have to be into that world, or else we probably won't be a match. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you're, you know, if that doesn't jive with you, you're not going to, you know, it's not going to work. No. And you need somebody that's more numbers oriented and, you know, not so, you have to have your business plan and all the dots, you know, the I's dotted and T's crossed when, you know, I don't know, maybe you could tell me if I'm wrong, but for us creatives, where, you know, I want to go with the feel. Like, I don't really care about a launch. I'm done with it.
100%.
So.
And I also, you know, I would say that most of the time my clients or potential clients fall into the category of either female or gender fluid. Mm-hmm. And they're usually in their 40s and 50s.
Right.
So, like, Gen X is kind of my sweet spot.
Right.
You don't have to be, but that's sort of my jam.
Yeah, this is what, what resonates. Why do you think this is important, what you're doing?
That's such a great question. So as someone who's been in the wellness and sort of spiritual, spaces and industry, if you will, for 15 plus years now, what I've seen over and over is tremendously gifted individuals that have a heart of gold. They really want to help people. They're really passionate about what they do, but they don't feel like they deserve to make money from it, or that they only feel like they can make just enough to get by, but it's going to be this blood, sweat, and tears, constant hustle thing. And that is a narrative that I think is so important to challenge. Like, why do we think it's bad to make money from doing something like that? It's really a win-win.
Right.
You get to be in your zone of genius. You get to be living your dharma, living your purpose, helping people, and you get to be abundant, in the process. So I've just seen so many practitioners totally burnt out, 6-7 days a week, hustling, barely getting by. And after observing that pattern for so long, I was like, what's going on? It doesn't have to be this way.
Well, I'm in that category of, people, because people think that, that you should do this stuff for free.
Exactly.
People want, and those aren't the kind of people that I want in my life anyway, because they have a lack mentality.
Amen.
But they think that, but I will say on the, maybe that's what you attract because, especially depending on your religious upbringing, that it's, you're supposed, do you just give it all away because it's a gift from God?
Exactly.
And people think it's they want free stuff. They think that you should, and they don't understand that. How do you put a price tag on the divine? Like, if you're connected, if I'm of the light, and correct me if I'm wrong, if I'm of the light and I'm working to help you understand what the divine wants from you or what your connection is or whatever that is, how do you even put a price tag on it? It's millions of dollars. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you can't put it, it's just more than you could ever, it's worth way more. But people will spend money on stuff that is, you know, it's not, it doesn't help their lives be any happier.
Exactly. Like it's a Band-Aid or a quick fix or an instant gratification thing.
Right.
Yeah.
So how did you get into this?
Let's see. So I have been doing astrology readings for the longest. That started about 15 years ago. Then in 2009, I became certified in yoga, and I started teaching yoga. A couple years after that, I got trained in Reiki one and two. So I kept kind of adding these holistic things, you know, into my bag of tricks or whatever. And then, you know, I managed a yoga studio at one point. I taught at multiple different yoga studios and wellness centers. And that along that journey it was during that journey that I really saw in myself and other people kind of in similar fields feeling like we're underpaid, we're hardly making any money, but we're busting our butts. And so I started taking some coaching programs for myself and reading a ton of books on money mindset and things like that. And I personally began to experience a transformation where, if I'm being honest, I never had more than maybe $3,000 in my bank account at any given time. And then the bills came and that number would go almost to zero.
Right.
I have like $97,000 in there right now. You know, like living how I used to be, you know? And so then I was like, this is so important that I want to help other people who are kind of in similar, you know, similar fields. And so I began coaching in 2020. And that has been amazing.
I love it. So I want to make sure that we get everything in. Are you running any special programs right now or in the near future?
Yes. So one thing is if anybody is into astrology and wants to learn more because they just love it, or if they even would like to read charts professionally, I have a 6-week astrology school that's starting in January 12th. So that should be fun. Also, this is something that I'm just putting out there to whoever is listening. I ran this sale for Black Friday, and I would extend it to anyone that could possibly be interested here. It is 5 coaching sessions for $9.99. And that is about 40% less than what it normally costs. So that's 5 coaching sessions. Yeah. So just FYI, if anyone is interested.
How can people find you?
I am primarily on Facebook and Instagram. I feel like I'm a little nervous about TikTok and all that. I haven't gone there. I haven't gone there yet. But yeah, Facebook, Instagram, or my website. Yeah.
I love it. Well, will you come back?
I'd love to come back. Yes.
All righty. Thank you, Allison. It was great to have you. If you're ready to get your biz in front of over 100K peeps, email me at steph@juststeph.com. Next hour, we have the Just Steph Rules of Dating, your soul reading, and your social 411, and Chris Carr of Launch Mechanic. More biz advice.
WATD FM Marshfield.
Thank you, Allison. Thank you. Ciao, ciao. Okay. Okay. Yay. Woo. That was such great business advice. Let me see if I have your number. All right, everybody. We got a great, great, great rest of the show. Hang tight. And if you're watching this, say hi. And if not, you're watching it later, do hashtag replay so I know. Oh, God. Let's see what we got. All right. All right. I screwed up the, I pulled a divine energy card instead of a grace card at the beginning. So I'll pull a grace card later. Oh, why am I backwards? Hi there, whoever's watching, you said hello. Thank you for tuning in. Okay.
Rhea from the Women of Boston Lingerie, and you are listening to the Just Steph Show.
Thanks, Maria. You're the best. Love you. So we're back. Call me.
Call me anytime. Call me.
All right, so call in if you have any questions or any comments. Tell me what you're doing for the holidays, whatever you want. Or maybe even ask me here if you're watching on social media. Ask me in the chat, and I can answer your questions here as well. So it's time for the Just Steph Rules of Dating, and it's ready. Here we go. The Just Steph Rules of Dating is brought to you by the Women of Boston Lingerie, where you can feel beautiful and sexy regardless of your shape, size, or age. Check it out at www.thewomenofboston.com. And this is dating advice for second lifers, and it's the Just Steph Rules of Dating. All right, I'm going to pull a love card first. That's going to make you see what's going on. All right. If you're tuning in, this card's for you. Oh, this is awesome. You know what? You can't make this stuff up, you know. Slow down. Pause and allow things to unfold. This time of year, you really want to rest, rejuvenate. You know, I got invited to do something Thursday night with girls, and I'm traveling this week, and I have business events, and I had to say no because I just didn't want to be out every single night and just not feeling good. And I have a wedding on Friday. So it's crazy. So take this time. And even in in the relationships. Slow down. You know, a lot of times we're running around this time of year. Maybe instead of being crazy, you take one afternoon and do nothing with your significant other and relax. So that's it. That's your love card. So I want to talk about letting your guard down, because I think this is a big deal, especially as we get older. We sort of paint the new person in our life with the same brush as the last, you know, few relationships. And we bring some of those preconceived notions and what happened before forward. And we put up a wall, even us older folks, we put up a wall, even though we shouldn't. I don't know. Oh, there's a should. I shouldn't be shoulding on you. But, you know, we put up a wall to protect ourselves or to protect our hearts. But I think that we could be vulnerable and let that guard down and still maintain our, you know, our dignity and our confidence and not sort of give it all away and be hurt. You can definitely do this by, you know, engaging in proper conversations, tough conversations, and all of that. But I think what you need to do first, if you're in a brand new relationship, I mean, in my opinion, the best thing you can do for yourself is be authentic. Be your authentic self from day one, because you might not want to spill the beans on everything and let everything out because, you know, you got to save something for date number two. But if you're, you know, be who you are, because if you're not, eventually it will come out and you're already attached to somebody. And then, you know, you're going to look at each other and say, who are you? Because now all of a sudden they're crazy came out or some other weird stuff that they're doing. Be your weird self now. I mean, be goofy. I mean, do whatever, you know, be who you are right up front. Because first of all, the best gift you can, I said it before, the best gift you can give anybody is the gift of self. So with that said, with your being or your authentic self, create a safe space for your significant other, whether they're new or, you know, let it be a non-judgment zone. Now, don't get me wrong. I mean, if some crazy stuff comes out and you got some red flags, keep it in the back of the mind, you know, because, you know, down the road, you don't want to have problems, especially if they're boundaries that you know, are your rules that you'd never want to disrespect, you know, whatever that is. Like you find out halfway through the date that they don't have a job and they're in debt and they're living in their mother's basement. You know, don't go, oh, they're cute, so I'm going to hang. I'm going to see how this works out. You know, that might not be a good, say, you know, fix your life and call me, right? Yeah, you get the crazies. And you know, we all know this, especially in the online dating space, there can be some misconceptions, but I'm a believer that most people are good. They're good people, even if they're different. And if you have a good dating profile and if you are your authentic self and you're the person that you behave like the person that you want in your life, loving, kind, all of those things, those characteristics that you want in a person, you will attract that. And even if they're not Mr. or Miss Right, you will have met somebody nice and kind and you've met a new person. And there's nothing wrong with that at all. You know, I had many great dates that were not people that I wanted to go out with the second time, but they were nice people. And I was happy to have met them and to get a nice dinner. So here's some ways that you can let your guard down. First of all, you want to trust your instincts and sort of if you'll know, if you listen to your body, listen to your intuition, you'll know what you want to sort of spill out. definitely don't be a fake about your personality or, you know, have a front. Present yourself, don't present yourself as someone you're not, because you don't want, you know, you don't want to have any issues down the road, which is what I just talked about. I don't know why this is a problem, why someone has to do this, but practice honesty. Like, why do you have to practice that? Because if you do have to practice that, I think there's a problem with you being a liar. So, you know, be straightforward, I guess. I mean, some people like to, you know, like to have their messages delivered with, you know, candy coated, but be straightforward about, you know, your life, your needs, you know, speaking your mind, but you can do that in a kind way. You can do it in a soft way. But if you feel mistreated in a relationship or if you feel like there's something that is important to you, then, you know, say what you need to say and be clear, you know, be clear about your intentions. You know, we talked about boundaries last week, create healthier boundaries and make sure that you want to make it a non-judgmental like this. You know, you can have a safe space to talk where you can say things and discuss things with each other that might be a little bit difficult. Do not play games. If you're in your 50s and you're playing games in the dating world, there's something really wrong. You know, oh, I'm not going to call him, or I'm going to wait, or, you know, I'm going to see what happens, you know, or whatever. Are you going to say things that will be manipulative? You know, none of that. Just be straightforward. And if you want to talk to somebody, what is the big deal? Call them. I wouldn't be crazy and keep calling them and calling them and calling them if they're not answering the phone, because obviously they're avoiding. Maybe they're ghosting you. But, you know, everybody's worried, you know, should I do this? Don't play games. Be who you are. Show up and be authentic. If you're interested, be interested. If you're not interested, you're not interested. Be honest. Be upfront. Don't pretend. Take one step at a time. So here's some other things. You can communicate your needs openly. And talk about your values and your passion. So, you know, if you're on the first few dates, I mean, talking about what's important. What's important in your life? What, you know, family values? What do you love to do? What are your passions? One way to be vulnerable is to talk about what scares you. You know, like, I'm scared of heights. But, you know, talking about things like that, be a good listener. Love yourself first. Take care of yourself. Accept and validate your emotions and learn to let the past go. And that's what I was talking about a little bit earlier. Let the past go. And, you know, and understand that some conversations are going to be difficult. And, you know, I think we're so afraid to have these conversations because we think we're going to lose somebody. But if we lose somebody after a difficult conversation, they're not really meant to be in your life. And make sure you breathe. Don't blame the way you're behaving on your past relationships. Accept yourself and be patient with yourself. Bottom line, you're trying, and that in itself is everything. So if you need help getting on track, getting yourself aligned so that you can attract your soulmate, make an appointment with me. It's steph@juststeph.com. Take a risk, be vulnerable, share your heart, and love always. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, your soul reading and Chris Carr, who is going to help us with our businesses. Okay. And how was that? Let your guard down, people. I love all this music. I wish I could share it on Facebook. How was that? Good. Are you vulnerable, Jimmy? Jimmy, are you, you're so cute, nice.
Everybody's watching.
Oh, they, oh, they said it was great. Yay. Yeah. Okay. So, what is everybody doing? Laughing. What is everybody doing this weekend? You can for a minute. Come say hi. There's Jimmy. Hi. Oh, Jimmy, you're so nice.
Okay. I said hi.
There you go. Oh my God. So anyway, so how's it, what's everybody doing for Christmas? Let's see. She's going to use the phone. Yes. Oh, you cook. Yeah, I'm going to cook Christmas Day, but Christmas Eve. Yeah, Christmas Eve. I'm going to go to my cousin's. Thank God. Oh my God. Jimmy's dying for fish. Some fishes. He loves that. My kids love that too. Last year. Last year. You do Christmas Eve. Yeah, I vowed I'll never do another Christmas Eve. I'll go out to eat before I do it. I don't want to do it. I like Christmas Day. We relax. Last year. Last year. I love this. Next year. Next year.
Hey everyone, if you know me, you know I'm a super clean freak. This is Steph Palermo, and I've got to tell you about an amazing cleaning product. These days, everyone is fed up with unnecessary chemicals and additives. Me too. So let me tell you about an all-in-one household product, Annie's Pure and Simple. I know what you're thinking. I was thinking it too. What about COVID? Rest easy. Annie has got you covered. Annie makes her products from natural ingredients that are proven to kill germs and viruses, including the COVID-19 virus. And they're surface friendly as well as streak and smear free. And guess what else? It's safe for the kiddos and the pets. It's one cleaner for all your cleaning needs. Women owned and manufactured right here on the South Shore. Annie's Pure and Simple. Change the way you clean. Available online at anniespureandsimple.com and your local Whole Foods supermarket.
Do you yearn to reconnect to that sacred part of yourself in the midst of the jungles of Costa Rica? Well, Healing Vibrations Reiki and Sound Healing of Plymouth, Massachusetts is offering a unique nature consciousness retreat in the lush rainforest of the Osa Peninsula, Costa Rica, this February 19th through the 25th. The Osa Peninsula is one of the most biologically diverse places on the planet. It is here at the Luna Lodge, a world-renowned eco resort, where literally comfort meets the wild, where you will commune with the essence of your spirit and inflame the wisdom of your heart. Lori Fitzpatrick, a spiritual healer, and her partner, Michael Balonis, an avid naturalist and nutritional practitioner, will guide you on a daily practice of yoga, meditation, earth communion, and healthy eating. If this message speaks to your heart, you can call Lori at 508-360-6316 or email her at heal@sacredcrossing.com.
All right. Your soul is restless until you are living in your purpose. And here's this week's soul guidance. All right. So I am going to pull a grace card because I pulled a divine energy card at the beginning. I'm backwards today. So I'm going to pull a grace card. Here we go. Honor. Care for your soul. I can't make this stuff up. Care for your soul. Honor the divinity within you by practicing extreme self-care. Are you kidding me? What do we talk about every single week? Okay. Care for your soul. Honor the divinity within you by practicing extreme self-care. Honor. Okay. So I want to talk to you a little bit about, I know this is, you're going to be like, Steph, why are you going to be so negative at this time of year? But this isn't really a negative thing. I want to talk to you about regrets because so many people regret what they did back then and what they're good. I don't want you to regret. First of all, whatever happened. I don't regret anything in my life that, you know, even the good, the bad, the ugly, whatever, the awful, the torturous. It took me to where I am right now, and I'm the best that I have ever been in my life. So if you can think about everything that has happened to you in that light, it will help. But I, you know, they're end of life regrets. And I want to talk to you about this because if you maybe change a couple of these, you can maybe have your soul can be liberated. You'll be at peace. Anything where you feel peaceful and you're breathing and there's no stress, this is what I'm talking about. So here are a bunch. I did a little bit of digging around a couple of different articles. So here are some things. I wish I had the courage to live a life true to myself, not the life others expected of me. And we talked about this on the show because this is the most common regret of all. And I want you to live your life. The life that your family has set up for you is not your life. Just because they did things for 120 years, and I'm not talking about the fun, nice traditions like, you know, eating fish on Christmas Eve, even though if you want to change that, go ahead. I'm talking about the fact, you know, what they think, you know, life should look like. You know, I always tell the story. My mother said, I just want you to settle down. I said, what does that mean, Mom? I'm not watching Judge Judy every night and you know, sitting on the couch. You know, I am going to, you know, fly around and do the fun things. I mean, I'm getting on a plane tomorrow. I have to get on a plane tomorrow at 6 o'clock in the morning. And, you know, it just, I have to do it. I'll sleep when I can. It is what it is. But that's because I'm doing things that I love to do. And I will sleep because I already made plans for tomorrow night to really sleep well. So anyway, because I am going to take care of myself. Here's number two. I wish I hadn't worked so hard. And this is something that, you know, we work so hard. We don't spend time with our families, especially when they, you know, you're young, you're a young family, you know, in your 30s and you're trying to support your family, especially in these days, and you miss out on, you know, your kids' games and plays and all things, you know, all of that stuff. And you miss out on couple time because you're just always running and working so hard. And, you know, I think the one benefit about being an entrepreneur is you can work around what you want to do, which is nice. And you can set it up so that you can, you know, have time to relax. Number three, I wish I'd had the courage to express my feelings. You know, a lot of when we suppress those feelings, especially when it, you know, it's all about relationships every day. I mean, it's all about relationships, whether it's love relationships, family, your coworkers, your bosses, your friends, anybody that you come into contact with, you know, being able to express your true feelings instead of expressing like, gee, that really hurt my feelings, or I really felt bad when you said that. You can say things in a nice way. You suppress your feelings to keep the peace. It's, you know, peace above all things, right? And sometimes that doesn't work out for you because you haven't been true to yourself. I wish I had stayed in touch with my friends. This was one of the biggest regrets that I had about, I mean, talk about regrets. The things that I felt the worst about, because it's not really a regret, because when I lived in Atlanta for 27 years, I grew as a person like I would have never done anywhere else. So I'm grateful for that and thankful, but it was really hard to be, you know, when you have four kids and everything's going on, it was really hard to stay in close contact with friends. And that's something that, I missed everybody's kids growing up. So that would have been something nice. So staying in touch with your friends is important. I wish I had let myself be happier. You know, we let ourselves, we keep ourselves miserable. We don't allow ourselves to be happy. Here's some other thing, a few others. Doing what we love, knowing who we are, prioritizing our values, living in the moment. We're always, you know, we talked about living in the past, worrying about the future, daring, you know, being a little, be a little risk taker. You know, people always say to me, oh my gosh, I can't believe you just go, you know, to Sicily and you do this and you do that, because, you know, they're used to somebody who goes to an office and sits down at a desk, and I don't live my life that way. But to me, it's just living. And for a lot of people, it's taking big risks. Here's one I want to do. It's on my bucket list. Learning a second language. I want to be more fluent. I'm not fluent in Italian. I do okay, but I'm not fluent. Learn a second language. Expanding our worldviews. Travel does this. Travel offers an education that you cannot find in a book. It helps you to release prejudices, preconceived notions. You learn different cultures. A worldview comes, I think, of course, reading is important, but it's not what you're going to see on the news. It's what you're going to experience when you meet the kind people of different countries. That's, you'll never regret having traveled. You know, you'll say, oh, I don't have the money now, but when you're getting ready to cross over, you will have, wished that you did. Giving back, being generous. People think, oh, I don't have the money, or I can't do that. And I have this conversation often with people, you know, especially about giving, you know, at church. And in my mind, it is one way I can give back and to see the good things going on and give back to programs and be happy that I can do so. And it helps with the money mindset as well. Taking a stand for ourselves, a lot of us just let things go, and we allow ourselves to be run over and then backed up. They back up and finish the job, and we never stand up for ourselves again to keep peace. I mean, I did that. I'm doing it today, every day, because of my kids. You can start a war. But I imagine there must be a way to stand up for yourself where everyone just doesn't fall apart at some point. So, yeah. So regrets, I think that it's a terrible way to live life, regretting everything, every decision you've made. And
if you need help releasing that, you definitely want to email me at steph@juststeph.com and let's get you happy with where you are right now and understanding your amazingness, because it's really important to release all of that. And make sure you give me a call, 781-837-4900. Call in with any questions or comments. If you're watching on social media, you can ask me questions or make comments in the chat. And we're coming up to our second featured biz. And is she, do we have a caller? We do have a caller. Okay. So, I was worried about that. So I have Christine Carr on the line. Christine Carr has helped hundreds of people from all over the world as they pursue their dream of owning their own businesses. Her secret sauce is her ability to curate for small businesses, ecosystems, or villages of people with diverse industry and business skills who want to see small businesses succeed. With experts and a range of resources all pulling in the same direction, these entrepreneurs have a much greater chance of making their dreams a reality. Chris is the co-founder of the CTA at Boston. It's a Canadian technology accelerator, an award-winning program to help Canadian technology companies grow in the United States. Her most current iteration of an accelerator is called Spring Launch, a virtual accelerator for veteran-owned businesses. Supported by a grant from Verizon, Spring Launch delivered a successful pilot this fall and is now getting ready to scale. Chris is the CEO of Launch Mechanic and is currently contracted by Verizon to run a program called SBDR, Small Business Digital Ready. Hi, Chris.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm terrific. I've been listening in. I love your program.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad you tuned in. Thank you so much. I'm glad to have you here. I mean, man, what aren't you doing?
Well, thank you for having me.
Yeah.
So I love one of your last points. You were talking about international travel, and you were just bringing me back to all the places that I've been in my life. And I do think it's important not to have any regrets as well.
Yeah, it really is. And you and I, we talked offline about a lot of stuff like this. So I'm glad that, you know, great minds think alike, right? So tell us about your work. Like, why does this work matter? What are you doing? And what exactly did I just read? And why does this matter?
Well, the reason why it matters to me is, in my opinion anyways, I think that more than any other time in my life, there's many people out there who are just searching for meaning in their lives. And I think if you stop and just take a look back at what we've all gone through over the last several years, mm-hmm. People are really spending a lot of time these days just trying to figure out how they can have impact and, you know, what is it that they really care about? And what that means for practitioners like me, and I've been working with entrepreneurs and small businesses for many years now, we've just never seen so many people who want to pursue their passion. And what I feel like is that they're just trying to realize their full potential.
Yes.
There are some examples of that. I mean, there has been a study on this. In particular, if you just look back the last 2 or 3 years, there's of all the small businesses out there, 30% are owned by women. And in the last 2 or 3 years, the number of women-owned businesses has increased by about 10%. So if you think about the fact that there's 12 million small businesses owned by women, and then you add another million that were just created in the last 2 to 3 years, it's just a phenomenal sort of testament to what's on people's minds.
Yeah, I love it. Yeah, I think people, you know, this is the age. People go, I'm tired of being an accountant. I want to be a dog groomer or something. You know, they want to do something different that lights their, you know, that keeps their pilot light going. So, yeah, I love it. So why do you think people suddenly feel like they can cast aside their safe, predictable sources of income and workplaces for entrepreneurship? I mean, it's pretty scary.
It's a big leap. I think the reason why we're seeing so many people start to do this right now is because during this little period of time we just all went through in mm-hmm. this country, in my opinion, I feel that we faced an existential crisis. And many of us just began to question our lives and how we're spending our time. And once we're all faced with just being with our families and neighborhoods and communities, we started to realize that the people that could help us the most, you know, during a time of crisis was they were right in our backyard. And so I think that could be a driver or, you know, at least an influencing factor for wanting to give back or for wanting to be someone who can solve a problem. But I think more importantly, about feeling connected to other people and then recognizing that you really want to be a more active player in the human experience and in the context of creating that experience yourself.
Yeah, I definitely feel that as well with all of this. I know for so many it was such a negative situation, but it really, you know, everything happens, you know, it ends up for the good. And if it causes you to look inside and to grow as a person, then it's done its job in my opinion. So I love that. Let's assume that people do want to create an experience for themselves, as you put it. What does that look like and how does it unfold?
Yeah, I mean, I just want to respond to your reaction, which is I think it was a difficult time for people also. And it certainly wasn't easy for me. But if you could find that place where you could move through it and get to the other side and be able to back on it, it could be empowering for some people. Yes. I guess it was for many women anyways, and I think many other people as well. But if you decide that you want to go forward with starting your own business, what it typically looks like, the way to think about it is it comes in two different forms. So there are basically two types of business paths that you can choose. The first is what we call a lifestyle business. And these are the kinds of businesses that make up the majority of businesses in our country. And the second one is what we call a growth business. And these are the minority, but these are the ones that get all the press. So when you think about a growth business, the owner is purely focused on generating revenue and growing and creating value for shareholders. So you want to think about big companies like Facebook and Airbnb. And again, they're just focused purely on generating revenue. So when we look at how this really unfolds in the real world, we have all of our Main Street businesses, which I would categorize as lifestyle businesses, and they are the backbone of this country. And these are not to be outdone by all of the small businesses that exist off Main Street, and even in our backyards, in our own properties, and in industrial parks. And these also exist all around this country. Those are all lifestyle businesses. So regardless of where they are or what they've chosen, in general, it unfolds like this. It starts with, for everybody, I have a great idea, and I think it could be a great business.
All right, so what happens next?
Well, this is part of why I'm drawn to this, but what happens next is that, for me, this is the stuff that movies are really made out of. You know, it is grit and hard yards. It takes a lot of strategy. It can be painful. It also can be joyous and exhilarating. It can be exhausting. It can bring you great hope, and it also shows how you can adapt, and you can also resign. So you can experience everything that you would experience in a whole lifetime, except in a very concentrated way, a much shorter span of time if you start your own business.
Well, you know, you can't go straight to the joy and exhilaration then?
No.
You know, I think a lot of that it's a parallel to life because when you do become an entrepreneur and you start your own business, I think you have to all those limiting beliefs start. You can't bury them anymore because it starts to come up. If you want to be successful, then you have to release. I mean, that's kind of what I'm getting out of this.
I mean, for sure. Setting aside the fact that this is a lifestyle and a piece of income for you, this is also a chance for you to grow in so many ways.
So if that's the case, why are people drawn to such an exhaustive emotional state to do this?
I mean, we're all people, but I would say that there are certain qualities that entrepreneurs have, and the ones who are particularly successful and can make it over the long haul, I usually sort of characterize some of these personalities in four different ways. I would say, for one, they have to have an expertise, and it has to be a deep expertise in something. And secondly, they have to be very persistent individuals, just somebody who just keeps trying and is almost scientific in a way. And then third one would be you have to have a great clarity and focus, hyper-focus. And above all, you have to have guts.
Yeah, and a thick skin.
Thick skin is right.
Thick skin as an entrepreneur. I know because that's me. So the thick skin is tough. So let's say that, you know, I have all that. What's the first thing? I want to start my business. What do I need to do first?
What we know for a fact from studying hundreds of businesses is that the number one reason why businesses fail is because they run out of money. And the reason they run out of money is because they really didn't clearly define or understand the problem that they were trying to solve. So in other words, they thought they knew the problem, but in fact, the real problem escaped them, and they got so focused on the problem that they believed was the priority that they missed it. So when you start a business, the most important thing you can do, what I call MIT, the most important thing, is to take your idea to the customer that you believe will buy it, give that person your solution. Then, and this is the most important part of the exercise, and it's where 98% of entrepreneurs really fall down, when you hand that solution over to that first customer, there's something instrumental, the next step that you can take. It's called listen and believe.
Right.
Listen and believe what your customer is saying.
So you're saying that most entrepreneurs actually have the problem identified before them correctly, but they miss it because they didn't listen and they got focused on the product they already had in mind.
Yes, that's the most common mistake that we all make, and I've done it myself many times.
So let's say that they do listen and they're able to adjust their product to that newly identified need. What happens next?
This is my favorite part of entrepreneurship. I think it's the most fun. If you have listened, and I mean, this is what we all wait for, this one moment. If you've listened to your customer and you believe what they said about the problem, then you have to design. This is where all the creative part comes in. You have to design according to what the customer told you. That means you have to actually solve the problem with a product that they asked for. And this is called proof of concept. And if you can get to proof of concept with a customer, you are at least on the right path. It's a very big first milestone, and it's also a stepping stone.
Okay, so you know what, we're getting close to your time, so I want to make sure we talk about what the SBDR. So can you tell us about that?
Yeah, for sure. Well, there's a tremendous resource out there called SBDR, which stands for Small Business Digital Ready, and basically it has dozens of introductory and advanced business courses on it. It is totally sponsored for free by Verizon as part of their corporate social responsibility mission. And there are thousands of businesses using this platform today. I really think that if you can get past that first step where you're taking a leap and you're saying, I want to turn my great idea into a business, that one of the best things you can do is to sign up to this platform and just educate yourself as much as you can as an entrepreneur.
I love it. That's awesome. How can they find it?
Well, go to this link. If you want, I can just go ahead and spell it out for you. But you want to go to HTTPS. So it's /// bit.ly link. So it's bit.ly /3RTSB0. That's my special link. And if you have any problems with that, you can also go to my website, which is launchmechanic.com/village.
I love it. So yeah, you know what? I will get this link out at least on social media, and you know, we'll make sure that people have it, because I think it's a great resource. I'm excited. So what would you say? You know, what are a few words of advice if you want to start a business?
If you have a great idea and you think it can be a great business, go do these three things. First of all, validate your business with an actual potential customer, like we talked about a few minutes ago. Go to SBDR tonight, educate yourself, learn how to register your company, select the right legal structure, set up your website and search engines. And then three, and this was told to me by one of my advisors, don't take no for an answer.
I love it. Persistence. Yep. Perseverance. I love it. That's awesome.
Right.
And how can people find you again?
So go to launchmechanic.com/village.
I love it. Will you come back?
Oh, I'd love to come back. Thank you so much for having me.
I love really having fun. You. Thank you, Chris. All right. Take care and Merry Christmas. Thank you. If you're ready to get your biz in front of over 100K peeps, email me at steph@juststeph.com. We're going to take a short break. And when we come back, your social 411.
Merry Christmas, happy holiday.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas.
I gotta shut that off. Sorry, I can't. They can't have the music on Facebook. I was gonna ask you something, but I can't remember. Oh, someone said hi, Jimmy. Mm-hmm. I think it was Maria. Maria Paula.
Hi, Jimmy.
Oh, gosh.
I understand. You all right?
Yeah, I'm just tired.
Yeah. You alive?
Yeah, right now. I'm live. I'm, you know what? I've been working since 8 o'clock this morning.
I know.
So it's fun. It's good. It's all good. I got a lot of stuff done. Yeah. I did the wrong cards at the beginning. It was all backwards. I said, was saying things backwards. Oh, well.
Okay.
Okay, Bloss. All right. I'm listening to the music. I'm like totally zoning out. What about you guys? If you're still listening, I love you, really. Yes, I got my go. I totally forgot what I was doing. I swear to God, I'm having like a senior moment. So I hope everybody has a nice Christmas. I get stuff to do, but it's all going to be good. It's all good. Does anybody feel like they need a vacation, like to do nothing? I want to do nothing. Like, I want to go to Sicily and do nothing. And just be. I wish you guys could hear them. I wish Facebook wasn't such a pain about the music, because the songs are so good. I love these Christmas songs that I picked. Give me a little rose quartz. And happy holidays. Yeah, you want to take a break. Me, I know. Just want to relax. I'm relaxed, though. I'm pretty good. All right.
Steph fans.
Here we go.
Let me ask you a few questions. Do you want to incorporate a spiritual practice into your routine? Do you want to have more fun and create meaning in your life? Are you so done with the hamster wheel days? I get it, and you can change all that. What if I told you, you can come to Sicily with me for 8 nights and your life will never be the same again? You will rub elbows with the locals, visit sacred sites, learn how to cook authentic Sicilian dishes, incorporate a spiritual routine into your day, and transform your life to leave a legacy you can be proud of. You do not want to miss this unique opportunity to learn ancient ways and experience the beauty of Sicily. This is exclusive, 6 people max. This is not your typical bus tour. It's all inclusive except airfare, and I'm going to take exceptional care of you. Get out of Dodge this February 5th through the 13th. That's right, 2023. Check out all the deets at juststeph.com and click Soul Journey Retreats, or email me at steph@juststeph.com. Don't miss Sicily with Steph. Hi, everybody. It's Candy O'Terry. Here's Just Steph. What a show, right? 95.9 WATD, the South Shore's radio station.
All right. Your Social 411 is sponsored by Sun City Tanning on Church Street in Pembroke, Mass. Tan lines, never. A visit to Sun City means sexy, flawless skin that promises to turn heads. Call and ask us how we can improve your health like professional athletes with their photo biomodulation chamber at 781-826-2605. Living happens during leisure. That's where the body is refreshed, the heart is moved, the spirit is lifted, and the mind expanded. You wanted to know where to go this weekend. You've been waiting for your Social 411.
I said you hallelujah, 'cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. 'Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. 'Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
All right, thanks, Larry. You know, today I want, you know, I want to talk to you about. I'm going to talk to you about where to eat Christmas Day. I have a few places, but I also am going to tell you a little bit about New Year's Eve because I want you to get a head start. So here's some good places. So Alcove at 50 Lovejoy Wharf in Boston, has a nice dinner planned and some Christmas, specials. This is very special. Ristorante Fiore. It's on Hanover Street in the North End. They are hosting Christmas Day dinner, but here's the deal. It's a goodbye party for them. Fiore's is closing. I know everybody loved Fiore's because they had the nice rooftop bar, but Fiore Colella is retiring and Frankie DiPasquale has purchased Fiore's and he's resurrecting the restaurant and nightclub Umbria, or at least some semblance of it. So if you remember Umbria, it was in the financial district. It used to be El Panino years ago. That was a fun place. If you want to say goodbye to Fiore's and enjoy Christmas Day dinner out, head over to Fiore's. Another great restaurant, another Frankie D restaurant, Mare, is having a Christmas Day dinner. Grana at the Langham on 250 Franklin Street is hosting dinner. Now, the Boston Harbor Hotel has a blowout brunch. Now, here's the deal. It's $210 per person. And or $80 if you're 12 and under. I imagine it's amazing. If you've ever been to any of those really the big hotels, the fancy hotels, brunches, they've got everything. And Contessa is having a 4-course dinner from 12 to 7 p.m. And that's $195 per person. Okay. So here's what's going on for New Year's Eve. Jimmy and I are going to be at Nando on Hanover Street in the North End. It's our favorite place, and it's a really fun New Year's Eve. We love it there. So if you come out to Nando, call over there, get a reservation. If you're, we're going to be there a little later, and make sure you come over and say hi to Just Steph and Just Jimmy. And so, so New Year's Eve, here's some fun stuff that's going on New Year's Eve, other than what's going on at Nando. Now, this could be super fun at this is at 3 p.m. Harpoon Brewery, and that's over in the Seaport, is having karaoke, and it's at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, 3 to 8 p.m. So if you want to pregame New Year's Eve, go do karaoke at Harpoon Brewery. Also, we have a high society New Year's Eve party at the W in Boston. You want to just Google that. There's, you know, food and drinks and all of that. That's at the W. I'm sure it's going to be super fun. Now, there's a great event at Hurricanes. That's in the Boston Garden. And it's, the tickets are $50, non-refundable. And there's, you know, lots of stuff happening there. There's Dress to Impress for the biggest party night of the year, dance to the music from their DJ. Tickets include food favors and a champagne toast. And all sales are final, and what is it, $50. So you definitely want to get your tickets now for that. That's at Hurricane in the Boston Garden. At Faneuil Hall, it's MIJA. It's this is from $300, and it's an event by 617 Productions and they're the kings of Boston nightlife. I need a magnifying glass. And they have so much going on. There's live DJ, there's complimentary champagne toast at midnight, past appetizers, party favors, there's large group. There's I think it's in many places. It's the gallery at the W Hotel, there's a nightclub there, Havana nightclub, lots of stuff happening at that. You want to Google that because it's New Year's Eve and it's with Faneuil Hall at Faneuil Hall. There's a New Year's Eve comedy show at the Marriott Boston in Quincy. And that is, it's both nights, Saturday, December 31st, but there's two shows, an early one and a late one. So you definitely want to Google that one. Now, here's something that's super fun is Dee's Keys Dueling Pianos. You definitely want to check them out. They are a blast. Next week, I'm going to have more New Year's stuff for you to tune into. So definitely grab my book. Next week, I have Katie Creedon from Your Own Your Wellness and Joe Masley from CrossFit Marshfield. Thank you to my guests and all of my sponsors. Grab my book, email me, come to Sicily with me, join my Facebook community, and don't miss a sexy Monday. See you next week. Know I love you all. Wishing you love, balance, and peace. Ciao, ciao, baby. Love you. Okay, kids. I love you. Ciao, ciao. Bye. See you next week.